Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic electrophiles and nucleophiles. Hello friends, we are not talking about electrophiles and nucleophiles. So this is the term that we have got to know in the difference between the carbocation and carbon in the previous lecture. So what is actually electrophiles and nucleophiles? So basically these are the nothing but these are the reagents that would be reacted with the substrate, and so these are of the two types that we are going to talk about. So therefore let us talk about it in detail. So now before understanding what is electrophile and nucleophiles, we should understand what are reagents. So let me give an example. That is, suppose when methyl bromide is being treated with the aqueous solution of KOH. So in this case, basically, if the hydrolysis, we could call it as the hydrolysis of the methyl bromide. And in this case, the product that we could get is basically, it is CH3OH plus KBr. So in this case, basically, I would say that the CH3Br is basically known as substrate, while this KOH is known as reagent. So what we need is we have to convert the basic substrate into a product that is known as an alcohol over here, that is methyl alcohol, while this KBr is a byproduct. So that's the reason that we have to change that substrate with the help of the reagent or with the help of a species that could be able to change that substrate into a desired one. So that's the reason that this KOH or potassium hydroxide is called to be reagent. But this reagent can be of two types, that is nucleophilic reagent as well as electrophilic reagent, which are commonly known as electrophiles and nucleophiles respectively. So what are electrophiles and what are nucleophiles, and how does it play a vital role in the reaction? So that is what we are going to talk about. So let us understand that. So now let us talk about what are electrophiles. So according to the definition of this one, that is the species which are electron deficients are called to be electrophiles. So as we have suggested the name earlier also, electro means the one which is negative and phile means the one which is attractive but towards the negative charged one. So who is attracted toward the negative charged species? The one who is itself a positive one. So that's the reason the one which has a positive charge, and that's the reason that they have electron and they are known to be electron deficient. So that's the reason that we could say that they have the tendency to attack electron rich centers in a substrate. So they will attack the electron rich centers in the substrate, and that's the reason that we could get a desired product. And that's the reason that they are called to be Lewis acids, because they have the tendency to attack that or they have the tendency to attract the one which has more electron rich or the one which is more electron rich species. So that is the reason that they are called to be Lewis acids. And talking about the next one, that is they are positively charged species like H plus and NO2 plus. So these are being positively charged, so obviously they will attack lone pair of electron towards themselves, and that's the reason that we could call it as Lewis acid, and they have the tendency to attach with that of a negative species. But meanwhile, it is not necessary that always a positively charged species should be an electrophile. But yes, there are also the neutral molecules, like as you could see over here, that is the neutral molecules with incomplete octet of electrons like BF3, AlCl3, ZnCl2. Even this reagents or this acts like an electrophilic reagents or electrophiles. So this is what I wanted to explain. And so depending on the reaction can be an electrophilic reaction or a nucleophilic reaction. So this plays a very vital role in converting a particular substrate into a desired product one. So now let us understand the next one that I'm going to talk about, that is nucleophiles. So nucleophiles are opposite of that of the electrophile, and let us understand that in a detail. That is, nucleophiles are basically the electron rich species, and that's the reason that they are called as nucleophiles, because they are itself that is negative charge, but they will attack towards the one which is basically positive charged species. They will attack the positive charged species. So therefore they have the tendency to attack electron deficient center or the one which is positively charged in a substrate. So nucleophiles are basically known as Lewis base, because they have a lone pair of electron, or they have the tendency to give out the electron to the one which is more electron deficient, and that's the reason that they are called Lewis base. And talking about the last one, that is that is That is, they are negatively charged species like OH, Cl minus, Cn minus. This all are the negative charged species, and hence they are known as nucleophiles. But it is not necessary that every negative charged species is basically a nucleophile, because there are also neutral, subneutral molecules which are the one which show like which are behaving like electrophilic reagents, and that is basically like that of RnH2, because it consists of lone pair of electrons over here, as you could see. So these are basically the neutral molecules, and even they behave like nucleophilic reagents. And because obviously that we could see that one or more lone pair of electrons that are been present in it. So therefore, in nitrogen, when it comes to in ammonia, you could see that one lone pair of electron is been present over here. While in this case, basically two lone pair of electrons will be present on the oxygen atom when it comes to an alcohol. So that's it, and that is what I wanted to explain to you. And thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you'll share this video with friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Geeta channel. Thank you so much.